How to use just a single password for everything. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got. Can you use just one password for everything you need one for? Having a lot of different ones is really hard to remember, to the point where I've had to write each one down. There are two approaches to using a single password everywhere. There's the really, really bad approach and the really, really good approach. Let me tell you what I mean. First of all, when we talk about just one password, using a single password in multiple places, we're literally talking about, you know, your user ID at Gmail is your email address and this one password. Your user ID at Microsoft is your email address and that one password. And throughout all of the accounts. Of course, this is one of the major ways that people's accounts get hacked. One of those accounts gets hacked and the password gets discovered. As a result, hackers with that password in hand now use that password to try all of the other services that they're routinely trying to break into. And chances are, one of those services is going to be one that you have an account at. And if you've used the same password as you did in the first account, they've got access to that account and all of the other accounts for which you happened to use that one password. Indeed, this is the very, very bad approach that I mentioned at the beginning. This is not what you want to do. In an ideal world, you would use a completely different password for every login. In an ideal world, each one of those passwords would be long and super complicated. In an ideal world, you'd remember them all. But as we know, this is not an ideal world. The way to use a single password so that you literally only have to remember a single password is to use a password vault. That's the really, really good way to do it. Password vaults like 1Password. It's in the name. The only password you need to remember is the 1Password for your 1Password master vault. All the other stuff is in the vault, stored securely. It's encrypted. It's whatever you care about to make sure that it is as secure as possible. And I use 1Password as an example. It's what I use myself, but there are many, many different good solutions out there. 1Password happens to use a cloud service so that you can share your vault across different machines and even portions thereof with other trusted individuals. If that's not something you want to do, there are other solutions that don't use cloud services. Whatever. In all those cases, there is one and only 1Password you need to remember, and that is the password to your vault. Now, there is kind of a third solution. It's not really, really bad. It's not really, really good, but it's something to think about. And that is using an algorithm. An algorithm means you have a set of rules so that when you come to a site for which you need to generate a password, you follow the rules in your algorithm. For example, in the article I have outlined, the first three letters of the site URL, the first three characters of the name of your first pet, spelled backwards, your age on your birthday in the year 2010, plus a number like 333. Three characters indicating what the site is about, perhaps BAN for bank or EMA for email or that kind of thing. And then maybe, if you need it, a special character if it's required, and maybe an incrementing number or some number elsewhere that you can use should you be required to change the password in the future. It's not perfect. In theory, you don't have to remember the password. In theory, all you have to remember is the algorithm, and you can reconstruct the password from scratch when you revisit that site. Again, it's not perfect, and I honestly don't suggest you use this specific algorithm that I've laid out because there are problems. But if you can come up with an algorithm that will allow you to generate appropriately secure passwords, secure enough passwords, on the fly, it's something in between really, really bad and really, really good. To be honest, I do both. I use 1Password all over the place. However, some passwords need to be typed in. And those can be frustrating. The scenario that I'm thinking of, for example, is if I need to type a password into my streaming service on a TV set, right? They don't have the sign in using your computer scenario. They actually make you laboriously type in some password on the screen. The issue then is that you want to come up with something that's as easy as possible to type and yet still secure. An algorithm kind of sort of solves that problem. You can come up with a multi-word passphrase that makes sense, that is easier to type. But that's really about the only time. My really strong recommendation is, yeah, use a password vault. It is better than every other alternative, and it lets you do everything by remembering only a single password. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/3511. I'm Leo Notenboom. This is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.